Hi, those that have followed my videos in the early stages would have noticed that I used to do TOEIC videos specifically from this book, and then I stopped because obviously the difficulty and the time that it takes to do the summary. 所以之前呢，我有做一些影片有关于这本书的内容，然后因为我个人觉得自学的话呢，如果用这本书的话呢，如果你程度没有到会很困难，那更何况是初学者，所以后来觉得我没有把握让听众可以把这本书学好，所以我后来我就不做了。因为我不想要就是随便分享这个内容，因为不然看过就那个应该说要是效果不好我也觉得很可惜。那好像以我的YouTube 的统计来看呢，好像多益对大家好像还蛮有共鸣的，所以这个周末呢就想说我是不是应该要在多做一些有关于多益的影片，即使它的难度有点高，加上我本身比较适合于教中高级的学生，对，所以你自己本身基础要很好。那因为有人有兴趣，然后呢，又有这本书，所以我也想要顺便分享一下我是怎么去教这本书的，Like I said, it's not the perfect way to teach, but this is just my experience. OK, 那简单分享一下。当然单字的部分呢就是先介绍，然后当你遇到听力的部分，呢，这本书很好，就是它后面有那个它的文字，听力的文字，那学生听一遍直接没有字的听，然后呢，要是他还弄不清楚的话呢，就给他们参考后面的文字，然后如果可以的话呢，请他们朗读这样子。所以千万不要把这本书当作是一个模拟练习考试，虽然说它其实是很多模拟的题目，可是要是你只是把它当成模拟题目，那你可能写完就没有太大的效果，一定要一直复习它这样子。Okay, now let's begin. So this lesson is about job advertising and recruiting. Okay, start with the keywords. Abundant, accomplishment, bring together, candidate, come up with, commensurate, match, profile, qualifications, recruit,Submit and time consuming. 比较特别的单字呢，应该就是 commensurate. OK, 相当的。那待会如果遇到的话，我再介绍它的同义字。So as you can see, you know, I just read the words once, and you know, it's expected that you know the meaning. 因为我只念一次，然后影片时间我也不想拉太长，所以本身一定要事先预习很重要。OK, words in context.Recruiting employees is a time-consuming and costly process. Therefore, employers want to match the right person with the right job the first time around. There are many ways to recruit good employees: advertising in newspapers and professional journals, recruiting on college campuses or at conferences, or getting referrals from headhunters. Recruiting is a time for a company to brag about its accomplishments. 对不起，我打错了。Accomplishments. Oh, 不能打。对不起。To brag about its accomplishments. Sorry. Okay. 希望不要再错了。And excite people about its future. Each company is trying to bring together the best and the brightest, but they are not alone.Their competition is trying to do the same thing. When jobs are abundant and there is low unemployment, employers may face higher demands from job seekers. Conversely, when the economy is slowing down and jobs are few, employers are in a better position for attracting the best candidates. Employers look for certain characteristics and qualifications in their employees, coming up with a very specific profile that fits the company culture and the specific job requirements is a difficult job. Employers want to see a well-rounded candidate and someone who has related work experience. They're willing to offer a salary that is commensurate with that experience. Employers will make hiring and salary determinations based on the information candidates submit throughout the application and interview process. 你们觉得听完完全不知道讲什么, okay? 多义的难度商业英文其实就是这种东西, 就是用一些很奇怪单词, 讲的就是很官方, okay? 那其实不用担心, 单字有背话呢, 就可以很好的拆解。 所以雇佣呢, 雇佣员工, 是一个很耗时间跟很花费的过程, 因此呢, 雇主呢, 通常要找一个, 希望可以在第一次, 可以找到适合的人选。 First time around, 这个字呢, 是可有可无, 可无, 可有可无, 因为呢, 如果人家念, the right person with the right job the first time, 这个around只是一个比较口语的说法, okay? There are many ways to recruit good employees, 很多方法找到好的, 雇, 好的员工, recruit good employees, 雇主, 诶? 中文叫什么? 突然一直忘记这中文叫什么? 雇主跟雇什么? 中文叫什么? Employee 雇员啊, 对不起, 我知道叫员工, 可是一直想用雇这个字。 Okay, anyway, 所以说, 要找到好员工, 可以用很多方法, 比如说报纸刊登, 然后比较职业的一些, 周刊啊, 季刊啊, 甚至在校园招募, 国际会议或大型会议, 甚至呢, 从猎人头那边, 取得一些推荐, referrals from headhunter. 这个referral这个字呢, 很重要, 把它记起来, 为什么? 因为referral这个字呢, 除了讲推荐或介绍呢, 国外医疗的时候呢, 想要转诊, 也是用这个字, 那这个字呢, 就是叫medical referral, okay? Medical referral, okay, 这样子。 Recruiting is a time for company, okay, 所以, 雇佣的时期呢, 也是公司可以炫耀他们的成就, 以及让他人呢, 对未来呢, 可以感到兴奋或刺激。 每公司呢, 都想要bring together, 这个bring together就是叫组织啊, 组织最好的跟最聪明的, brightest就是讲最聪明的, 对, 那可是呢, 不是只有一个公司这么做, 他们的competition, 这边讲的competition就是竞争对手, 所以不止这些公司想要找最好的, 每一个公司都想要找最好的, okay? 所以当工作呢, 是很, 当工作的职缺, 很多的时候呢, 然后呢, 又, 叫什么, low unemployment 叫做, 诶, 中文叫什么, 一直不知道中文翻译怎么, 就是失业率比较低, 对不起, 失业率很低的时候呢, 雇主呢, 就可以, 会从求职者呢, 遇到更多的要求, 相反的, 如果说, 经济缓慢, 然后工作少的话呢, 雇主呢, 就比较, 雇主的, 雇主的情况呢, 就比较有利, 因为他可以吸引到更好的那个, 求职者, 有点像增多周少的感觉。 Employers look for certain characters, 所以雇主呢, 都看某些特质, 跟一些资格, 然后呢, 找出一个他们适合公司文化的, 跟他们工作岗位, 相关的, 对, 就是每个人都有一个特别的文化, 所以找一个适合公司的。 Employers want to see, okay, well-rounded is something, or is someone is real well-rounded, it just means that they have positive attributes in many aspects, 就全面性的很好的, okay? They're willing to offer a salary, 所以雇主找到很好的话呢, 当然都会提供一个很, 跟他的经验是成正比, 或相关的, 薪水。 那 employees will make hiring and salary determinations based on information candidates. Okay. 所以说，当然要怎么样评估薪资呢？ 就透过求职者所提供的一些 资讯 等等 跟面试过程。 Commensurate 这个字我想要讨论。 Commensurate is something. 这边如果要改这个字的话， they're willing to offer a salary that is commensurate with that experience. Another way of saying that we can say they are willing to offer a salary that is, that is, 看一下。 commensurate IT commensurate. They offer willing to offer a salary that is appropriate to that salary, or that is in proportion to. 因为 commensurate 是相当嘛，或成正比，所以说，公司一定会给一个适合你的经验、你的能力的薪资。哦，这句话这样讲。OK， 这一篇算是还蛮难的。Again， 我只是随便乱讲，所以仔细你们要仔，就是有兴趣的人要仔细，多看至少三遍。OK， 那听力部分呢？Like I said, 虽然说我不讨论，那如果你们或者是有人有这本书的话呢 ，When you listen to it the first time, just listen to the questions and pretend that this is an actual test. And even if you get the questions right, make sure you're able to recite the dialogues. 如果你真的要很强，你想要考到金证，那你不只要答对这个答案，你也要能够记得起来，甚至写出或者是听得出来他们的对话内容。OK， 这才是就是挑战自己这样子。OK， last activity. Part 5, incomplete sentences. Your resume shows you have accomplished a great deal in your last position. 11. This program is used to scan resumes and search for keywords that match. 12. It is illegal to profile candidates based on gender or ethnicity. 13. The applicants who qualify will be flown to the corporate office and interviewed there. 14. After reading the job profile, she knew she was qualified for the position. 15. After submitting all his materials, he had no option but to sit back and wait for some response. OK, 第十题 resume 就是履历嘛，CV 也是一样。OK, 所以说你的履历呢，显示说你在你上一个职缺或职位呢，成就了很有很大的成就。OK, 11. This program is OK, 所以这个软体呢，可以扫描那个履历表。那这边讲的当然就是数位履历表。OK, 然后可以找一些关键字。那 会找到符合的关键字。这个简单来讲呢，之前呢，就是有些企业呢，他们在收到电子或 Word 档的履历表的时候呢，他们都会看你有哪些关键字是符合公司的，比如说你可能用一些很有毅力、很会时间管理等等，那他们就会，因为他们不可能一个一个看，那所以他们就用这种软体去扫所有的那个履历这样子。不过现在有些公司用纸本，所以不可能扫描。12. It is legal to profile. 这边讲 profile 就是当动词 ，OK? Profile 可以当动词。一开，他这边书是讲名词简介，可是当动词的时候呢，就是说你去把别人不知道这个不知道怎么讲。If you profile someone, 你就是去把它分类辨别的意思。看有没有更好的意思。If you profile someone, you刚刚没有动词。OK, profile, 好，那我就用这个样子 racial profiling, 种族梦想，应该不是这样子吧 ？Gender, OK, 就可以把它帮我分析了。OK, 就是你不应该，对不起，你不应该把求职，你不应该以性别或者是种族去分析或者是区别或者是过滤的求职者。对，那这其实在西方国家很讲究，不过那是未来有机会再讨论。 13. The applicants who apply, 所以求职者呢，如果说他符合这个职缺，那他就会去他们的类似他们的总部然后去面试。 Flown to, 这个很重要， will be flown to 是用 past participle。14. After reading the job profile, 这个 profile 当名词了，所以在阅读后个工作简介之后呢，这女孩子知道说她适合或她有资格应征这个工作，这个职缺。 15. After submitting, after 后面动名词，所以缴交她的资料之后呢，她只能等待回复。 OK, 简单来讲就是这样子。 OK, so, like I said at the beginning of the video, This book is very challenging if you intend to study alone. 一个人读的话是非常困难，因为它是属于中高等级的内容。那我的影片呢，又是坦白说就是随便乱讲 ，so it's not very helpful, but it's definitely useful in a way that you know, like the keywords and stuff. 如果你要准备的话，其实你可以看一些我之前画给学生的一些关键字。But by all means, please don't use this book as your only source of preparation for TOEIC. 至少找一本有中文的书，这样比较好，可以帮你辅助准备多益这考试。这本书它有很大的难度。Okay.